Today on Upfront, the candidates for lieutenant governor go head-to-head. Republican incumbent Rebecca Kleefisch and her Democratic challenger, Mahlon Mitchell. It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. It's a sprint to the finish line. We're a little more than 3 weeks away from Wisconsin's historic recall election for the governor, lieutenant governor, and four state Senate seats. Republican Governor Scott Walker and Milwaukee Mayor Tom Barrett celebrated wins Tuesday night. But while the top of the ticket is getting most of the headlines, today we're focusing on the lieutenant governor's race. Republican incumbent Rebecca Kleefisch and Democrat Mahlon Mitchell, president of the Professional Firefighters of Wisconsin, the State Firefighters Union, are here with us today. Thanks to both of you for joining us on Upfront. Well, let me begin with a simple question. This is an office without constitutionally defined responsibilities. Why should this matter to the people of Wisconsin, this election?
Well, it matters in particular right now because our state constitution dictates that the governor and lieutenant governor are elected together. So in fall of 2010, you cast one vote for the governor and lieutenant governor. But what we have discovered in the constitution is that in this recall election, we are actually separate. So it matters a lot because you're going to cast one vote for governor, and then you're going to go down the ballot and you're going to cast another vote for lieutenant governor.
But philosophically, why does it matter?
Philosophically, it matters because you need someone with the experience and with their eye on the biggest challenges facing the state of Wisconsin. When I ran for lieutenant governor 2 years ago, I said that I wanted to help the state move forward, not backward. And I helped the governor balance a $3.6 billion budget deficit, and we're working hard in order to create jobs in this state. And that is how we move forward as a state.
Mahlon Mitchell, why should this matter?
It matters because this is the second highest office in the state. And it's an office that matters, and it's an office that the people want. That's why it's still there. And I look at the lieutenant governor's job as one of being a champion for the governor. The governor can't be every place all the time. So you got to be a liaison between community, which is the entire state of Wisconsin, and the governor's office. Boots on the ground, so to speak, the ear to the street, and talking to common people, middle-class citizens, about their needs, their values, and relaying that message to the governor.
Isn't this election really just a referendum on Governor Walker? Is it about her?
That's why I'm running. It's about Governor Walker, but it's also about my opponent here, because she has been a stamp, a rubber stamp for Governor Walker's policies. Now, she agrees with what the governor is doing, and that's fine. I disagree with what the governor's policies are, because they're dividing our state. I would bring our state back together. And that's why we're running. That's what me and Barrett Tick is going to provide.
He says you're a rubber stamp. Can you give any instances where you have disagreed philosophically with the governor, expressed reservations about policy initiatives, anything like that?
Well, that's one of the reasons, Mike and Mahlon, why it's so important that you have a governor and lieutenant governor who are not adversaries, who in fact are supporters of the same ideas. It's why our governor and lieutenant governor are elected on a ticket. You know, the governor and I talk about any difference of opinion, and it's why it's...
How often do you talk?
Well, we talk almost daily by text or telephone, but we also have weekly meetings as well. Every Monday we're face-to-face, and I think that's incredibly important because actually what you said, Mahlon, is a very key role for the lieutenant governor, listening to the people. It's why I have traveled the state as this administration's jobs ambassador, listening to our small business owners, our job creators, in order to find out how we can put more people back to work, and I'm proud of the fact that we've actually driven down our unemployment rate to 6.8%. Now, which is the lowest it's been since December of 2008.
I'm going to give him a chance to weigh in. You're smiling. Why are you smiling?
Well, because we're talking about an unemployment rate that's 6.8%, and you got to factor in seasonal employment into those statistics. But you look at what we've done. Over the past year, we've lost 23,900 jobs. We lost 4,300 jobs just last month. So when we're talking about employment rate, I think we got some miscue math here because we're number one or last, in any way you look at it, in the nation in job loss. So the reforms are not working. And with all due respect, I find it funny that we sit here and talk about the unemployment rate when we've lost jobs after jobs around in our state. And it's unfortunate.
Well, actually, we're talking about kind of an apples to oranges comparison. You're talking about total non-farm jobs, which is, you know, one of those statistics that's kind of hard to understand and distill. And what we measure success by is total private sector jobs. You know, there are a lot of people who don't like big government, and some of those jobs you're talking about were government jobs that we shed. We were able to lean up government. We've created 15,600 new private sector jobs just since January.
How many total since January of last year?
15,600 new jobs.
And private sector jobs, not 6,400 private sector jobs.
Well, Mike, when you look at these statistics and then you compare them to the mess that we came into when we first were sworn in, we had lost 150,000 jobs in 3 years in the prior years. And last year, yeah, we did struggle, but we were able to stop the tide, stem the job losses, and this year we've moved on. We're starting to create new jobs, which is really important when you compare the 6.8% unemployment rate to, say, Milwaukee's 10.4% unemployment rate, because we're talking about an opponent on the top of the ticket who is the CEO of Milwaukee, and we would much rather spread that 6.8% unemployment rate, which is still not good enough. Right. We still want to drive it down more. We would much rather spread that to Milwaukee, a low unemployment rate, than spread that 10.4% unemployment rate all
Mitchell,
across the state.
Let me have you respond to that in a moment. But the question might be asked, you've been a professional firefighter since the age of 20. You're now in your mid-30s. You're the head of your state union. What expertise would you bring to job creation? If you're talking about your disappointment with their record, what expertise would you bring?
Well, first and foremost, like you said, I am a firefighter. And firefighters, we have the ability to compromise. And we respond to people on the worst days of their lives normally. When someone calls 911, it's not a good situation. So we come in, help to hopefully stabilize the emergency. And we have an emergency right now at the state capitol. And we have job losses. And I don't necessarily agree with the lieutenant governor's math, but we're probably not going to agree on that. We lost 4,300 private sector jobs just last month is the truth of the matter, right? So I'm going to bring a common sense approach to common sense problems that we have, common sense solutions. We need infrastructure. We had a governor who gave over $1 billion back to the federal government for infrastructure here in our state, for jobs, education, and health care, all things that would bring jobs to this state, education to our state.
Would you have favored high-speed rail in the state?
I would have. Yes.
Uh-huh.
Because then we also, you got to attach on also Talgo, which is here in Milwaukee. And she talks about the Milwaukee jobless rate. Well, Talgo was here. That would definitely help Milwaukee create jobs here in our state. Right. So you got to, Milwaukee, we got to remember Milwaukee is in the state of Wisconsin. So
absolutely.
What happens at the state capitol actually affects Milwaukee as well.
Absolutely. That's why it's so important that we lift up and stop rooting against Wisconsin and rooting against Milwaukee. That's why it's important that we lift up Milwaukee and Wisconsin and stop criticizing our great state.
Final word. Go ahead. You have 10 seconds.
I totally agree with lifting up Milwaukee, and I was born in Milwaukee. That's what firefighters do. We come together and work on solutions and problems. And that's what I would bring to the state. But this divide was created by your administration with Governor Walker. It wasn't created by anyone else. But Governor Walker,
it was so important that we're going to talk about job creation.
We are talking about job creation.
And it is. But, sir, when you send out a letter encouraging folks to boycott more than 100 companies as the head of the firefighters union, I don't know how that helps job creation. We're talking about thousands of jobs dependent on
true.
These companies.
That's just not true. I didn't send out a letter to boycott 100 companies. You show me that letter, because that's not true.
Sure.
Let me take a break here, because I want to continue this jobs discussion and talk about other things, too, in the news. We'll continue with the lieutenant governor candidates on Upfront in just a moment.
Upfront with Mike Goucher, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.